Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS. Last time we took on Smash Run using Cloud, and this time, let me put him back to his normal outfit right there, this time we're gonna be playing through as Corrin. Now back in All-Star, we used the female alt, and we went with the dark one right here. So this time we're gonna use again one male, one female. So starting off with the male one, let's see, they're not that great, honestly. I mean, I feel like most people don't even play male Corrin. Let's go with this blue one. See how that looks. Let's take a look. I'll be honest. I pretty much only use female Corrin, honestly. But I usually go with like the dark one, or I think she had a pink-haired one that I like. Could be thinking of someone else, but this one's kind of nice. This guy, actually, this palette looks kind of like Alm, I think. And I only know who Alm is because of his amiibo. But you know. And maybe that's what it's based on. That'd be kind of neat if it was. And I forgot up throw turns me into a freaking dragon. Corrin's one of those characters that, like, they're there. And I always see them on the roster whenever I'm playing Smash. But I never actively, like, choose to play as them. You know, do you have characters like that? That can be, like, a comment question this time around. You guys have characters that, like, you'll look at and you'll be like, I could play as them. And then you just never do. Because I'd say Corrin is that for me right now, and I legitimately thought that was going to be a Mimikyu, but I'm glad that it wasn't. Alright, up this goes. Hello. Corrin's also got a ton of trivia. I feel like a lot of the DLC characters get just a bunch of trivia for whatever reason. Okay, well, I guess we're falling down. Like, it's almost as if they had more time to think of the trivia because they're DLC, I don't know. Also, we totally missed out on the platform that's above here. And apparently they don't want to give us any enemies to fight either. This run is not going great so far. They don't want to give us stuff to do. I'll take the... Well, I guess I won't take the Koopa Shell then. Is this going to go up? This is indeed. I thought that Scuttler was coming with us for a second, but I guess he didn't want to. Goodbye. And also you, Mr. Other Scuttler. Damn, smash to hit both sides, even though there was nothing on the other side. Glyer. I almost called you a Glyce, you are most definitely fire-based. I think there's another one. Yeah, he's coming back. Eh. Eh. Up smash! Up smash! Up smash! Fine. How are you still alive? Go away. Good god. Alright, let's see. I didn't really pay much attention to whatever the music is that's playing right now, but I like it. I didn't pay attention to the name of it, but I definitely recognize it. Like, I've heard it before. Alright, Corrin, we need some, like, attack boosts, because you're not really killing any of these things in one hit like you probably should be. Because, well, not even just one hit, just, like, a couple hits. Could you come out of the ground? Thank you. Alright, let's see. Let's go as far as we can. Oh, door. I will take a door. I am fine with a door. Hello, Shy Guys. Goodbye, Shy Guys. Hello, Kremlings. Goodbye, Kremlings. Hello, Petalil. And other... Okay. Well, I'm surprised Petalil is the one that's causing me issues right here. Scuttler? No. It's not happening. You? No. I'm not even going to push you off the... Well, I guess I'm going to push you off the stage. I was going to try and kill him the regular way, but never mind. We also got a bunch of speed powers right there, which I am not going to complain about. And arms that we don't really use. I don't really find much use for arms, unless it is weapon-based. I've completely forgotten what it is that it even like powers up. Was it throws? Was it weapons? I don't remember. But it's not a stat that I ever like look at. I'm not ever actively like, oh, we got to get more arm stats. You know? I think it is like items-based, but I could be wrong. No, not items-based. I think it's, like, weapons-based. I'm not 100% sure on that. We've looked it up in a previous episode. That was a long time ago. I don't remember what the answer was, so... We're not gonna... No! I wanted to fight the Dark Nut! Alright, well, I guess we don't get to fight the Dark Nut. We don't get to play the video game today, folks. This is such a strange-looking animation when you look at it like this. Like, just doing it over and over again, you can actually get a proper look at it. There you go. Koopa Shell is here, apparently. Go, Koopa. Alright, Rotart, you're mine. Even though I can probably kill something else a lot quicker than I can kill you. I want to kill the Rotart, because he's always so easy to kill. Alright. We don't get to play the video game today. Go away. And then Shy Guy. Dark Nut, no. I know I just said that I want to fight you, but not right now. There we go. Row Turret was the one who finished it off for us. He came through for us in the end. Alright, we've got to be like super speedy right now. Let's take a look. Actually, not even that much, but another Dark Nut? Are you serious? I know I said I wanted to fight that one, but that's because it was just me and him in that one area. On an actual, like, battle arena where we could fight, and then I got stuck in a cannon. I don't really want to fight him now. And there's this evil car thing that we haven't seen for a while. I'm just gonna go over here, if that's okay. I'm not, stop following me, evil car thing. I'm gonna counter all of you fools. And it's not gonna work. Nope. I'm dipping out of there and getting more arms. Screw you guys. Screw you guys, I'm going home. Not bad, Karin. Super duper speed right there, and arms, and defense. Alright, let's knock out some of this freaking boatload of trivia. Karin is the newest character to be introduced as playable in Smash 4 with Fire Emblem Fates post-dating Smash 4's release by 9 months in Japan and 16 months in North America. Karin also didn't make it into Smash 4, as Sakurai had thought there were already too many Fire Emblem characters in the game. However, the team convinced him that Karin would be a unique addition to the roster, so Sakurai allowed him to be playable, and then said screw it, and added even more Fire Emblem in the next game. Karin and Roy are the only DLC characters from the same universe. Karin is the only DLC newcomer that does not come packed with a stage, although downloading him on Smash Wii U adds the original version and rearrangement of the song Lost in Thoughts All Alone from Fire Emblem Fates to the existing Fire Emblem stages Castle Siege and Colosseum. The remix is also added in Smash 3DS as a Smash Run track. Additionally, trophies of Ryoma and Xander are added to the 3DS version. Karin is the only DLC newcomer to not be a third-party character. And Karin is the... Okay, this piece of trivia has a bunch of, like, bullet points beneath it, but I just read it as what it says, and it just says, Karin is the only Fire Emblem character. There's a follow-up, but that just... that made me laugh. Karin is the only Fire Emblem character with a multi-hitting dash attack and a multi-hitting stall then fall down aerial, who doesn't visibly use warp magic on their on-screen appearance, who has a different name for his counterattack in both English and Japanese, as well as the only counterattack that is written in kanji and that does not involve direct usage of his weapon, and whose special moves and final smash are all written in kanji in the Japanese version, as opposed to a few of the mentioned moves or ones instead written in katakana. Alright, we got through a bunch of trivia. Let's move on. There's even more, but... Alright, it's a team fight, and it's just a regular Smash on Spirit Train, of course. Oh boy. Oh boy, oh boy. Let's do this. Maybe this doesn't look like Alm, and I'm an idiot. I didn't get a chance to, like, turn around and look at my Alm amiibo. I'll try and do that between this, like, when we finish this fight, I'll try and get a look at that amiibo just to see, because I think Alm's hair is blue, but I could be wrong. Might be green. I don't really know Fire Emblem, so... I know amiibo, though. I have a lot of those. There we go. And there goes Lucina. Yoshi can make it back. Okay, good job. He's got one of those custom up bees where it, like, gets rid of the egg. Oh god, okay, moving away. Yoshi! Oh god! What? What? Okay. Don't think I've ever seen that happen before on Spirit Train. Oh, I'm attacking Yoshi. Whoops. That scared the crap out of me. I thought we weren't gonna make it back. Alright, I'm just gonna stand here and counter. No, the game knew. We gotta try and get rid of Lucina. Like, right now, ideally. Yeah. Like that. Kinda like that. Alright, let's take a look at Alm. I think his hair's green. I don't know, my room's dark right now, so I can't actually see him that well. We did the thing! Yoshi's pretty happy about it. Ooh, dragon helmet? How fitting for Karin. Neon suit, pirate outfit, and another pirate outfit. Okay. No fancy pirate hat, though. No fancy pirate hat. Alright, so when we use the female Karin and we use the dark one, I am now gonna go with this one. I love this color. I think it suits her very well, and I like that her hair is also pink. I like pink. That's not weird. I like pink. You know what else I like? Pink horizon beams, even though they're kind of purple, and meteor showers that are yellow. Let's go! Of course, DLC fighter, so no custom special moves. Let's go. Let's do this thing, folks. Dragon Fang shot. That's okay. I'll pass. Ready? Go! Oh, we got the menu theme. We just had this playing. You could have given us something else. I guess I could have just deselected it, but... Or deselected it as an option, but whatever. Alright, where do we want to go? I think I'm going to go for top left again, just because there's actually platforms up there. And they're not always there, so... Why the hell not? Let's do it. God, I love this version of Corrin. I don't know why they would even bother adding male Corrin. I'm also totally kidding, because they added male and female Robin. I'm still a little bit confused as to why Corrin got male and female amiibo, but Robin didn't. Same with Olimar and Alf. What? You know what? They should go back and re-release... Or not even re-release. Just release a few amiibo for those alts. You know, like, give us some Koopaling amiibo. Give us an Alf. Give us a female female Robin. Male Wii Fit trainer. You know, I think that's a money-making scheme right there. People would buy the crap out of those. You can also kind of tell just how much female Corrin is loved over male Corrin. Because male Corrin's amiibo, you can pretty much get for retail price still, whereas female Corrin's is like $50 or $60, which is a little bit ridiculous. And we fell down. Okay, I guess we're not going to the top left right now. Yeah, like, I've been trying to get female Corrin's amiibo for a while, because it's one of the ones I didn't get to pick up on launch. She's so expensive! People really liked female Corrin, so they bought them all. And now there's just none anywhere. You gotta buy them all secondhand, and they're all, like, for stupid prices. Defeat Clubberskull, where's he at? Oh, we're actually pretty close. I think we can do it. We're on 44, we've got Horizon Beams and Meteor Showers at the wazoo. Let's try this. Let's go for a freaking Clubberskull. Shall we? It's been a while since we've actually tried to fight one of these, so... Let's see. Our up B is not the fastest thing in the world, so it's taking a while. Hi- Oh god, he's ready. He was ready for me. He was ready for me. Okay. We didn't launch quite as far as we did that one time with Dr. Mario, but we still launched. Did you want all of these, bud? Because you can have all of these. Trust me. Did we even do anything to him? We died! Okay, we're right there, though, so we can at least... It at least put his neck, like, really close to him. He's coming to us, apparently. Okay. Oh, God, we're trapped in a corner with a Clubberskull. This scares me. He's not actually attacking, though. Okay, now he's attacking. Come on. We've got a little bit of time to kill him. Not too much, but a little bit. Come on. Come on. No! God, he does a lot. I mean, that was only 38, but his knockback is kind of ridiculous. Come on, I'm trying to smash attack right now. No, smash. Okay, get the little chainsaw thing. No. God, Clubberskull, you take a lot. Okay, I think I just killed him with a freaking jab or something, but that gave us a lot. All right, not bad. Not bad at all. I do not feel bad about that. I actually managed to take out a Clubberskull. Good God. Hello, Metroid. I just kind of jumped up into you. This is not like jumping up into an Ornn, where you just die immediately. A bunch of Tiki Buzz? Okay. Don't care too much for Tiki Buzz. I love that you can just bonk off of them, though. Like, boom. Even makes like a little boom sound when you jump off. Do it again. Do the dong. Dong. I love it. I love that sound. Oh. Oh, no. I've used up all of the things. Oh, good. Oh, good. Oh, good. Oh, good. All right, then. Well, this is not going to go well. We chainsaw you. That actually might work. Oh, and that pokes through. Because she doesn't sound too happy when she's doing it. Hurrah! Okay, oh, okay. Maybe. Maybe. If I had just done forward smashes from the beginning, then we might have actually had this. Oh, and it broke right after the timer again, of course. I feel like whenever we have those hard rooms, they always break right after the timer ends. It's like, aww, but you did it, but aww. Can we not make that? Can Corrin really not make that jump? Okay, good. Because I still kind of want to go to the left. And this platform doesn't want to take us up, so I guess we're jumping ourselves. Alright, give me this. Not you, Mr. Plasma Wisp. Plasm Wisp, whatever you are. Stop that, Mr. Scuttler. You like my jab? Because I've got a whole bunch of them. Alright, we're just gonna keep going. Get as high as we can, see if there's another worldly door. We haven't actually had a run end while we're in another worldly door. That'd be kind of interesting to see. You know, we're in like a Nirvana room or something and then the run ends. We haven't had that yet. Alright, how did we do? Decent speed, very good attack. Okay, not complaining about that. Our opponents are Bowser, Captain Falcon, and Greninja, it looks like. Alright, let's read the rest of the trivia. Korin's idle pose is based on their idle pose during battle in Fire Emblem Fates. Albeit in Smash 4, their sword is angled more downward and their right foot is slightly lifted. Humorously, they also keep this pose when paralyzed. Korin is the only character in Smash 4 with matching alt trophies in both versions of the game. Korin is one of the five characters who wears the same costume for their alt trophies in both the Wii U and 3DS versions. With the others being Robin, Bowser Jr., Cloud, and Bayonetta, which I guess makes sense because they all have pretty unique alts. Korin is one of the five characters to use different sound clips when using battering items, with the others being Roy, Ryu, Cloud, and Bayonetta, who all also happen to be DLC characters. Korin's alternate blast line KO clip of "How can this?" is a reference to their quote when defeated by an enemy in Fire Emblem Fates. This is also the second longest blast line KO clip in the game, behind Ganondorf's main KO clip. Lasting roughly a full second after the KO. If Korin respawns, they will do so before the clip is finished playing. This is more noticeable with the female Korin. Female Korin also has a unique voice line for teching, as she lets out a very noticeable "No!" I haven't noticed it, so it can't be that noticeable. I'm bad at teching. Both Korin voices have clips for taking high knockback which go unused in normal gameplay, as both Korins are always silent when being launched a far distance. These clips can only be heard in the sound test. Korin is the only playable character who does not possess a single move that can jab lock under normal circumstances. And finally, Korin, Roy, Ryu, Cloud, and Bayonetta's voice clips are in much lower quality than the rest of the cast in Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS. We've explained that same piece of trivia in all of the runs with those characters so far, and I'm sure that piece of trivia will pop up again for Bayonetta, who I think may have the most trivia out of any character so far, but we'll see. Also, Stamina Smash, a unique mode that we don't get all that often, that I am A-okay with playing right now. Obviously, we can still KO normally. If you just fall off the stage, your HP is gonna go to zero. I don't think they make you respawn. That's never been the case. In fact, Captain Falcon, I thought he was gonna test that theory for us, but I guess not. Oh, someone's got a bullet bill. Greninja, I think, has the bullet. Please use it. Please get rid of the bullet. Why am I slow? Oh, because Captain Falcon died. Okay. That's why we were slowed down. And now Greninja's dead. It's just me v Bowser. He's just attacking Greninja's dead body. Over you go. Wait a minute. We haven't taken a hit yet. Damageless run, baby. Damageless run. Not bad. And on Brinstar as well. Korin, you deserve it, barefoot waifu. Alright. Red shell hat, damn it. Alright, folks, with that, that is gonna go ahead and do it for this episode of Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS. Of course, next time, we're taking on Smash Run with the final non-Mii character, Bayonetta. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.